I'd like to discuss thread repair with you. And what I've done is I have threaded a half-inch fine hole, and I've purposely damaged it so I can show you thread repair. So as you can see, the bolt doesn't want to start in the hole because I've literally damaged the thread. So what I want to do is I want to repair this, and there are several different ways we can do it, and one way is with a thread insert. Now, the style of thread insert I'd like to show today is this style here. And I'm going to zoom in on that. And it looks very similar to a slinky, so it just pulls apart. And the inside diameter, once it's compressed into the threaded hole, will be the size of the thread we require, in this case, half inch fine. The outside is actually larger, so we're going to use a special tap that will be fit to the outside of this repair. And the outside is the same number of threads per inch as the inside, so it requires a special tap to do it. So in the kit, you will get a special tap. And this tap here, I'll see if I can zoom in on that a little bit. It actually has the size of the thread we require. In this case, it's half inch 20, which is a fine thread. Also, too, on it, it tells you the size of the drill that's required. So in this case, we will need a 33/64 drill, which is actually larger than half inch, because the outside of the tap has to fit the outside of the insert that's going in the hole. So this tap is only good for the insert. We also have an installation tool that we will end up winding this insert on. And we have a tool to pre-wind the insert on. And I will show how to do that. So we have this special drill, 33/64, for the outside diameter of the tap we're going to use for this repair, set up in the drill press, and it could be in a hand drill, and often it would be, especially if you were working on, say, a car part or something, automotive, maybe the engine of the car. So what we'll do is we'll turn it on, and we'll drill this hole out. The thread is now gone. Most taps, if they are larger, will have a hole in the end of it. And a trick I like to use is to put a center in the drill press and bring it down into the hole in the end of it, just to help start the tap square. Again, this is the tap that came with the insert repair kit. I'll just put a little bit of cutting oil on it. And we'll set it in the hole and put the tap handle on the top of it. And I'm just going to use the tap handle to drive it, but we'll bring the center down. And again, we need a tap for each size thread that we're going to repair, and also for the number of threads per inch, whether it's coarse or fine. So I'm just pulling down on the spindle of the drill press in order to get this tap started. And what I'm going to do is just back it off and turn the tap counterclockwise in order to break the chip. And then forward again, a couple of revolutions, back it off, and I just want to keep going until I get down through the hole. Couple of revolutions forward, back it off to break the chip. And we'll keep doing this till we get down through the material. These thread repairs are really nice for aluminum. If you have a damaged thread in aluminum housing, spark plug comes to mind right away. This is done quite often. It's a lot stronger thread once the insert is put in, rather than just the threaded aluminum. Alrighty, we're down through the hole. I'll just back it off. Get the tap up out of the hole. And you should be able to see that there is now a thread inside that hole. Alright, so we've now set this plate up in a vise in order to put the thread insert in. And we have our thread insert, and please notice there is a little tab at the bottom, and it actually has a notch on it. So after it's installed, we will end up taking this tab off or breaking it off. The reason for this little tab here is so when we put the installation tool on it, it actually drives on the bottom here. So what we'll do is we will take the insert and we will put it in the pre-winder. And the reason why is we need to shrink this insert. In other words, make the outside diameter smaller. So after we thread it into the hole, it's going to expand and it's going to hold on to the outside of the hole and making it stay in place. So we will end up taking this pre-winder and we will put the installation tool in and just start to wind it in. And you hopefully can see it starting to come through the bottom side there. So what we'll do is we'll just get it a little bit exposed and we'll put it over top of the hole and we will take our tap handle again and we will just start to wind it in. Just keeping an eye on it, seeing the insert coming through the bottom of the hole. And there it is there. So what I'll do is I'll take this pre-winder off so you can see it. I'm going to give it about another revolution just to get the insert down below the top surface. We'll take the tap handle off and we will remove the installation tool. Now what we could do is file the top of that surface flat. And the repair is actually inside the hole. Okay, here's the thread repair with the insert in the hole. You can see the tab at the bottom. Now we have to take a punch and we have to break this tab off. And it's as simple as that. Because of the notch on the underside of that insert, you just need to tap it with a hammer and it will be removed. Here's the finished product with the thread insert in it. And now we can thread that bolt in. Goes right through the part. And there's the finished product with the bolt in the hole. Here is our special tap. Again, the outside diameter is larger than the thread repair. There's the insert that went into it, the installation tool, and finally, the pre-winder so we can shrink the insert to fit into the hole. And that's all there is to it. These go by different trade names, such as helicoil or perma-coil is another brand name. And this is just one style of thread insert. That's it.